In the previous video, we have read and analyzed a model cause analysis paragraph, analyzed how to write a topic sentence, looked into how to write major supporting sentences, revised some linkers to write minor supporting sentences. Now, we will start analyzing how to write a concluding sentence in a cause analysis paragraph. Please note that you don't have to write a concluding sentence. Writing a concluding sentence is optional. There are different ways of writing a concluding sentence. First, you can mention ways to stop the causes or ways to cope with them. This means you can give advice. Let's think that you're writing a paragraph on the causes of global warming. This can be your concluding sentence. In conclusion, although there are many causes of global warming, reducing our carbon footprint may help to prevent it. The second way is evaluating the causes. Let's think that you're writing a paragraph on the causes of committing crimes. This can be your concluding sentence. In conclusion, when the causes of committing a crime are analyzed, it can be seen that it's not impossible to take action against them. Another way is making a prediction. Let's again think that you're writing about the causes of global warming. This can be your concluding sentence. In conclusion, if global warming continues at this rate, the next generations will face many natural disasters. Now, I'd like to mention some problems and give explanations about them. The first point I'd like to mention is about the order of ideas. You can order your ideas in your major supporting sentences from more obvious to the least obvious, from the most well-known to the least well-known, from the least important to the most important. Usually, writers want to keep the most significant points to the last. The second point I'd like to clarify is about hedging. What does hedging mean? In some cases, we cannot be 100% sure that the effect will happen. Usually, the effect happens in most people, but not in all people, all the time. We may make sentences which cover all the people, and it sounds too sure. In order to avoid over-certainty and sound more true, we can use certain structures. We usually use models to do this. For example, we can say, watching too much TV can harm a child's ability to focus on his studies. Here, using can avoids being too sure. Another example is watching TV too much or too closely may damage people's eyes. Here, the use of may helps us to avoid over-certainty. We can also do this by using some words, as in the next example. School kids who watch too much TV tend to, are likely to, usually, work less on their homework. Here, tend to, are likely to, and usually, help us not to overgeneralize the effect. Now, have a look at this piece of student writing and find the problematic uses. The first problem here is, by using everyone and nobody, the writer overgeneralizes the topic. It may not be true for everyone. It's best to say this way. Some people become unhappy at work. People may become unhappy at work. Certain offices make people unhappy. The second problem is, the writer says, offices are boring and ugly. However, we don't know if this is true for all the offices. Instead of that, the writer should say, some offices can be boring because of the monotonous work routines. Some offices may make workers unhappy due to the furniture or layout. Dark colors or poor design may affect their feelings negatively. The third problem is about the last sentence. This causes depression. This is too strong as a claim. Instead, the writer should say, boring work routines and ugly office design are linked to, may lead to, may cause depression. The third point I'd like to mention is giving trivial examples. Sometimes we want to give an example. The example should clearly explain the idea. It should not be too specific or personal. Have a look at this piece of writing and find the problematic use. The problem here is, I have no idea who your father is or what his office looks like. A better alternative can be this. Some workplaces are dark and gloomy. For example, coal mines usually tend to be dark because they are underground corridors. There is no sunlight and they use very little lighting there because it can heat up and cause an explosion. Another point I'd like to clarify is the inconsistency in pronoun use. If you use many different pronouns in one paragraph, it becomes difficult to understand and it disrupts the flow of your paragraph. Have a look at this piece of writing and identify the problematic uses. In this paragraph, many different subjects and pronouns are used. The writer used people, person, he or she, you, a student, he or she again, and we. While writing a paragraph, use the plural form. Don't say a student, use students. Also, this paragraph is about learners of English, so do not use people or person. Instead, use learners or students. Do not use he or she at all.